disassembling an FJ Cruiser half shaft. This is the inner, this is the outer. The inner is a tri-ball system. Looks like that. The outer is an actual Birfield, which looks like that. CV joint. So we're gonna disassemble this. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take the inside boot and pop it off. Lose the grease. And the boot itself is going to stay on until we take the inside star off. The star is held on by a single snap ring. So bands have been removed. Inside cup comes off, looks like a bell. Now we've got a star here. And we're gonna separate this just using a standard snap ring plier to pull the top off. There's a snap ring on the very top there. We're gonna remove that, that'll allow us to pull the star off, and then all the boots will come off in one piece. Snap ring pliers, snap ring comes off. Star comes off. Boot full of grease. More dirt. Now we can do the lower. The lower, I'm gonna stand it upright because it's full of liquid grease. That upright, we're gonna go ahead and break the seal down below and bring the boot up and slide the boot up and over it, exposing the Birfield. So we're gonna get the boot to come loose. Boot is off. We're going to empty the Birfield. We're going to put new grease in this one. We're not going to reuse the existing grease. So the grease is out, as much as we can get out. Still some in there, that's okay. Now we're gonna separate the axle from the Birfield. The commonly used technique by all the Tacoma guys and the IFS crowd is to tape off the top of the Birfield, put it in a abrasive cut chop saw, and cut it right there. And then once it's cut, they remove the tape, knock the spud inside the Birfield, and then disassemble the Birfield to retrieve the spud. And then you have to clean the whole Birfield and put it back together again. We're going to use a different technique. Metal Tech comes from a Land Cruiser background, all Land Cruisers, the old FJ40s. And therefore, we're going to use a Land Cruiser technique the guys have been using for years on how to remove a inner axle shaft from a Birfield. Instead of cutting it, we're going to use kinetic energy to get it to drop free. In order to do that, you need some rags, a hard surface, and a piece of tubing, or pipe, this is tubing in this case, in order to do it. So we're going to take a rag first, put it in the bottom of the tube, and this is what's going to retrieve the axle when it drops free. This will keep from it getting damaged. So we got a rag inside our tube. We got a nice hard surface. We We're going to drop it directly on there. What we're doing is we're taking the kinetic energy of the shaft and making it fall free in order to break the snap ring loose. The tube is going to be sitting on top of the star on the inside, this main star. And that main star is extremely strong and can withstand the impact. So we want to make sure the tube touches that. Make sure your tube is not on the cage. You don't want it on the cage or the bell of the Birfield. You want it to be on the star, so it has to be a decent size. We're using 2 inch 120 HERW tubing in this case. So we're going to take this, drop it down inside, and now it's sitting on that star. There's two techniques to doing this. One is taking the whole unit up and dropping it together. The other technique is taking this up and then slamming it downward on impact. And we're going to do that one on this one. It may take a few hits, but you'll get it. And it's drop free. Now we're able to take the tube, retrieve our axle, no cutting. So we now have a separated Birfield from the axle. The next thing you do though, is you want to look at your axle that just came out. You want to look for your clip and make sure that clip is there. If it's not, you got to go inside the Birfield and retrieve it. And in this case, we have exactly half a clip that's there. The other half is over here. So that means I have a half a clip inside the Birfield. So I'm just going to reach in there and retrieve the clip and pull it out. Right from that, we'll be able to dismantle the Birfield, clean it, and repack it. So we now have a complete axle, no cutting, no tape, no mess. Well, a lot of grease mess. Ready? So disassembling a... Go ahead. Maybe a smaller wreck. So,